If you are looking for a basic laptop for under $400, the Acer S5 equipped with a Ryzen 3 3200U might be a great choice. A quick Q&A, this or the Walmart Motile 14-inch laptop? I think this if you prefer a bigger screen, the Motile if you want a smaller and lighter laptop. The fuck is this shit? My sister and I chose this laptop for my mom for her birthday, and she would need one for her English online classes. With a full HD 15.5-inch IPS panel and a weight of 3.96 pounds, this would be an okay-ish machine for basic work and entertainment. On the right side, the laptop has a Kensington lock and one USB 2.0 port. On the left side, we have a charger port, a gigabit Ethernet port, HDMI, one USB 2, one USB 3, and an audio jack. Flip to the back, we can see the cooling system without opening the back panel, a single heat pipe connecting with a fan, which will suck air through the holes on the panel and exhaust to the back. As we know, the laptop only comes with 120GB of SSD and 4GB of RAM, so upgrading is definitely required. To open, there are 10 screws on the back, and you would need a pry tool to open. I don't recommend using a flathead screwdriver, because it's very slippery and you may scratch your laptop. And here is the internal components of the laptop. Overall, everything looks really neat and seems easy to assemble. We can take a closer look at the cooling system which I just mentioned. Occupying half of the internal components is this battery, which allows the laptop to last up to 7.5 hours of usage. Next, we have an M.2 NVMe 128GB SSD from HK Hynix. I could not find any information about this, so I will assume that it is just a DRAM-less, low-quality one. Next is the 4GB Samsung RAM stick. There's an extra slot to run the laptop in dual channels. Thanks to the size of the laptop, there's an extra space for a 2.5-inch hard drive / SSD. And on the back panel, there's a dampening foam to reduce the hard drive vibration. I would replace the original SSD with this 250GB Adata SU-800 SATA M.2 SSD. Even though it's not an NVMe drive, it does have DRAM cache, which will be great for using Acer boot drive. Plus, with double capacity, I could partition the C drive to be around 150GB while still having roughly 80GB of fast storage. Next, I will give this machine one stick of 16GB memory. Psych! 32GB of RAM should make this boy last for 10 years based on what it would be used for. For the 2.5-inch drive, first I unscrewed to remove the tray and the SATA header. This will reveal the ribbon cable that is double-sided taped. I haven't seen one since my Lenovo laptop, which I killed it 3 years ago. Damn, time flies quickly. Acer already included a small bag containing hard drive screws. I mounted this 8-year-old drive to the tray. Even though it's old, there's no drive error according to Crystal Disk Info. Next, I installed the ribbon cable to the SATA header. plug the header to the drive, then mount to the laptop. And finally, insert the ribbon cable to the motherboard. I thought everything was good to go, but turned out I could not use the M.2 SATA SSD. I replaced it with a 256GB Samsung PM961 NVMe M.2, which was previously used in my Ryzen PC system, and it could boot into the pre-installed Windows 10. So, I still don't know if this laptop can support SATA M.2 or just NVMe only. The heatsink I installed on the drive was too thick to close the back panel, so I just left the 1.5mm thermal pad on and hoped it could keep the drive from thermal throttled. With a fresh Windows 10 installed, the laptop is up and running. We can now check out the performance. The hinge allows the laptop to nearly lay flat, maybe useful for some people. The trackpad is big enough, and I feel the quality is usable as I can precisely tap on without using the left click. The keyboard is full size and is not separated from the laptop chassis, which is great in my opinion. The backlighting can be turned off, but if it's switched on, it will automatically turn off if the machine isn't used. Camera resolution is 720p and it's really not bad for Zoom conference. And while we are here, let's check out the screen. Thanks to being an IPS panel, the screen does not get darkened if it's being viewed from different direction, so it's a big plus. Even though I don't recommend using this laptop for gaming, but I am still very curious about its performance. My personal rule when gaming on laptops, they must always be plugged in. First is Assassin's Creed, the game which was released in 2007. At 1080p, it dipped to 37fps during in-game menu. I changed the resolution to 1600x900 with medium-low settings. It dropped below 50fps. Then I decided to set everything to low, and the game it was much more playable. FPS constantly stayed above 60. Next, I tested Assassin's Creed Pro, which was released in 2010. During the menu, I had to lower the resolution to 1280x720, with graphics settings were set to medium-low in order to raise the frame rate. During game, the frame rate stayed around 50. However, there were some stutters whenever the camera changed the angles during the cutscene, so I set all the settings to low. Even though it stays below 50fps sometimes, I think for this game it's still doing pretty okay. Well, as Rockstar likes to milk GTA 5, so do I. Here is my graphics settings for the game. Average FPS was around 40. CSGO is no longer the game we used to know. In my opinion, with constant updates and many additions to the game, it's very demanding. At 1024, 768 resolution, plus everything set to low, the game struggled between 60 and 90 FPS, and I felt the input delay was too much to handle. Plus, the game also gave me eye bleach, because everything was too blurry to see. It's a big no to use this laptop for competitive FPS unless you want to take many big L's. I had CSGO installed on the NVMe drive and the max temperature was 72 degrees C, so I guess using just the thermal pad helps. Here's the CPU temperature, peaking at just 81 degrees C. Not bad. And finally, this is the game that I can really enjoy without caring about graphics. This laptop has some pros and cons over the Walmart Mobile, so I hope this video can be useful if you plan to pick a $350 Ryzen laptop. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye bye.